One devotee asked me, what is this, Swamiji? When you spoke about Gita, you said Gita is the ultimate book. And now you say Shiva Sutra is the ultimate book. See, Gita is a beautiful book to start. It has got some little bit of Shastra, little bit of Stotra, a little bit of Sutra. There are some techniques, and there are some Stotra, the glory part, and there is a Shastra, which gives you the intellectual base. It's like a mix of everything. But the danger is, you may miss the essence. You may get caught in the Shastra or Stotra. You may lose the Sutra part. You may lose the technique part. It's a mixture. Whenever you mix, there is always problem. You may miss the essence. You may miss the truth. But here, you cannot miss the truth. It's a foolproof book. Anybody who goes through this book cannot miss. It's a foolproof technology. You can't escape. You can't miss the truth, because here nothing else is there. No sugar coating. Nothing. Straight away gives the truth. No teaching. No intellectual stuff. There is no need to avoid anything. There is no need to use your intellect to separate, to analyze what is truth and what is not truth. And you don't have to use your intellect at all. As far as this book concerned, straight away open and start practicing. It's a practical manual. It's a practical manual. That is why no teachings. This is not for the people who are yet to be convinced. It's a straight book for the people who want to practice. I have brought few stories to tell you all about the teachings, how teachings work. A patient goes to the psychiatric doctor and says, "Doctor, it is too much. I can't run my life. I don't know what I can do. But one thing, I can't live my life in the same way. Too much of problems." Psychiatrist says, "Yes, we all have problem. I know. Let's try to help each other. I'll start 4 sessions at a week. $100 per session. We'll start from tomorrow." Patient says, "Yes, doctor, I understand. This will solve your problem. What about mine?" So teachings may solve the problems of teacher, but not the student. Teachings may solve the problem of teacher, but not the student. All teachings, either it is given as a commandment or given as a theory. One thing, at least with commandment, you know directly commands are given to you. But when you start reading theologies, in a very cunning, subtle way, the commandments are inserted into your inner space. Logically, you are convinced. Logically, you are convinced to follow these rules. Logically, you are convinced about these teachings. Then great damage, permanent damage is done to your consciousness. Let me be very clear. Unless it becomes your experience, any teaching, it does only damage to your inner space. It does great damage to your consciousness. It is better to escape from teachings than having them without the experience. I have one more story. suddenly one day farmer noticed that one of his cow is missing, and there is a railroad near his farm, and he sued the railroad company thinking that cow has died, and company hired the best lawyer, big lawyer in the city, to settle the matter out of court. Somehow lawyer convinced the farmer. Farmer accepted 50% of what he was claiming and settled. After the settlement, after farmer signed the release form and took the check, lawyer felt really happy, and he was not able to keep quiet. He was talking about his victory, and he said, "I'm really happy I won the case, because I don't have a single witness. I can't stand in the court. I'm happy that we have settled out of court." Farmer said, "Yes, I'm also happy. I was also worried yesterday how to take only half of the amount, but today morning cow came back to the home. So I agreed." Be very clear, neither the farmer knows nor the lawyer knows what is going on. He is trying to cheat the other person is trying to cheat this person. Lawyer is thinking he is cheating the farmer, and farmer is thinking the other way. In the teachings also, the person who teaches, he is thinking, people are all listening, he is talking for them. People are sitting, they are thinking, anyhow, he is talking, what to do? I have to sit, I have come. It becomes a sort of a routine. It becomes sort of a routine. Anyhow, we are not going to do anything. He is going to speak. Let's have some good time.